Welcome into the Tuesday episode of the David Hookstead Show. As always, happy to have you all here. We got some fun, interesting topics to talk about. Right off the bat, we're going to talk about some comments made by a woman named Melissa Satta. Now, if I'm pronouncing any of this wrong, I apologize ahead of time. These are not Americans. So however it gets pronounced over in Europe, it could be completely different from what I'm saying. Don't take offense. I butcher people's names all the time. It's not personal whatsoever. So who's Melissa Satta? Melissa Satta was married to a soccer player by the name, and again, this could be wrong, Kevin-Prince Boateng, who is a high-level soccer player over in Europe. And he apparently had some health issues, some injuries that have been over the course of his career. And the major issue, allegedly, according to Melissa, is too much extracurricular activity in the bedroom. That's his ex-wife. Her exact quote, according to the Daily Star, was, "The reason why he is always injured is because we have sex 7 to 10 times a week. I hate foreplay. I want to get straight to the point." And then she goes on to make a little bit more graphic comments that I'm not going to repeat here right now. But you can read about them on dailycaller.com. But here's what I'm going to say about this, which is going to surprise some of you. The fact that, hold on one second, my fucking piece of shit computer. The fact that she's saying he got hurt from sexual relations should not actually surprise any of you. Now, I know many of you are probably saying, oh, that sounds crazy. That's nuts. There's no way that's possible. It actually is very real and very possible. I used to work in sports. I used to work in college sports specifically. I can tell you without obviously flaming anyone by name or anything of that nature, the way some people get injured, okay, outside of their sports would blow your mind, would absolutely blow your mind. So for this woman to be saying, hey, this guy has all these health issues, all these injuries off the field because he's having too much sex, that doesn't surprise me whatsoever. Now, it's a crazy story. Don't get me wrong. It's a little wild. It's a little wacky. It's a little nuts. Doesn't surprise me one bit, though. Not even a little bit. When you think about it, let's say you're not properly stretched. You're doing all this crazy stuff. You could easily pull a muscle. You could easily tear a muscle. You could easily throw out your back. I've seen just about everything that you can think of and everything in between when it comes to sports injuries you wouldn't expect. I mean, I've seen people slip on ice and miss time because they slipped and fell on ice. So if you can slip and fall on ice and miss time, you can miss time for just about anything. I know a guy that had to miss time because of an ingrown toenail. So again, the idea that sex is not going to cause you to potentially get hurt in a sports setting is just downright false. Also, this woman, Melissa Satta, I don't know anything about her. I think she's Italian. She's apparently must be relatively famous because when I looked her up, she has like 4 million followers. She has a ton of photos at high profile events. So, I mean, I guess good for them. I don't think they're married anymore. I believe they're divorced. I think they have one kid. But all I'm saying is don't write it off just because it sounds a little wacky that this guy could be getting injured from too much extracurricular activity in the bedroom. I mean, hey, you're not properly stretched. You're not in perfect shape. You try to do something crazy. You slip a disc. Who knows? Wild stuff happens. Happens all the time. Anyways, Falcon star Calvin Ridley. Calvin Ridley has been suspended for at least all of next season after he gambled on NFL games, which is a huge no-no. You got to remember, not only are NFL players not allowed to gamble on games, they're not even allowed to gamble on other professional and, I believe, college events. Can't gamble on the NBA, NHL, MLB, college football, college basketball, and I think they can't even gamble on the Olympics. And it's not like this is some rule that they're not well informed of, okay? It is made crystal clear to people involved in professional athletics, you cannot gamble on athletics. It is considered way too risky. One, you could have inside information. Two, if you allow gambling to seep into the locker room, you could have guys that end up doing really stupid stuff, throw games, things of that nature. The NFL had to drop the hammer here. But what blew my mind is then Calvin Ridley goes on Twitter and fires off these tweets. "I bet $1,500 total. I don't have a gambling problem. I couldn't even watch football at that point. Just going to be more healthy when I come back. I know it was wrong, but I'm getting 1 year. LOL. If you know me, you know my character." I don't know who's telling him to, like, who's holding his hand when it comes to the PR handling of this situation, but they need to get fired and or do their job. The last thing you want to do is start firing off tweets about how much money you gambled, claiming you don't have a problem. And I'm not saying he has a problem. If you only gambled $1,500, he's a multimillionaire. That's not a big deal. The fact is he shouldn't be defending these actions. Yes, the punishment is very firm. It's very stiff. Also, again, though, you knew the consequences. If you don't like the rules, get the rules changed. You can't break the rules and then complain about the rules. That's not how life works. So I feel bad that Calvin Ridley's going to lose a bunch. No, I don't. I actually don't even feel bad because at this point, it is what it is. I mean, you knew the rules. You broke the rules. It is a serious situation. You have no one but to blame but yourself. That's the reality of the matter. All right. Finally, HBO has a show about the 1980s Lakers called Winning Time. It's Winning Time something. Let me pull it up here. Winning Time, The Rise of the Lakers Dynasty. Okay. That's the name of the show. It has John C. Reilly, Jason Clark, a couple other prominent actors and actresses in it. And it follows Magic Johnson arriving on the Lakers after the 1979 draft, obviously becoming the face of the franchise with Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. And they won a ton of, you know, championships in the 80s. They were a dominant, dominant team. It is awesome. It is, I need a new TV show to watch while I wait for some other stuff to come out. It is outstanding in every sense of the word. It is quite frankly incredible. So I can't recommend it enough. I hope you all watch. It's awesome. I mean, it's got the glitz and the glamour. It's got the basketball aspect, obviously. It makes Jerry Buss look like the coolest guy in the world, quite frankly. I don't know anything about Jerry Buss. I know his daughter, I believe, posed for Playboy, and now she kind of runs the Lakers, if memory serves me correct. He looks like an absolute awesome dude, like the kind of guy you'd want to hang out with and drink beer with. So if you haven't seen it, it's called Winning Time, The Rise of the Lakers Dynasty. You can watch it on HBO. I watched the first episode last night. Loved it. Anyways, that's all we have for the Tuesday episode of the David Hookstead Show. I'll see you all back here Wednesday for another one.